Good morning to all of you. My name is Siddharth Bedi from the Chitkara School of Hospitality. Today we'll be talking about liquors like brandy, whiskey and tequila. We'll be first discussing the introduction to liquors, its various types. Then moving forward, we'll be discussing about the introduction for whiskey, its types and the brands which are available in the market. Then we would move on to brandy, discuss its introduction, its types and brands. And in the end, we will move on to tequila, its introduction, types and brands which are available in the market. Introduction to liquors. Liquor is an alcoholic drink produced by the distillation of grains, fruits or vegetables that have already gone through alcoholic fermentation. The origin of the word liquor and its close relative liquid was made from the Latin word liquor, meaning to be fluid. Here in this photograph below, you can see various types of liquors like vodka, rum, gin, brandy, tequila, whiskey, which are used and are popular in the market these days. If we talk about the basic classification, alcoholic beverages can be divided into three basic parts: fermented, brewed, and fermented and distilled. So the first one we have is fermented, which are your wines, cider and perry. Cider is made with apples and perry is made with plum. Then brewed and fermented we have beer and sake, which is made with rice in Japan. And in the distilled category we have spirits, which are your rum, gin, vodka, tequila and brandy. Liqueurs like Curacao, Cointreau and UDV, your fruit brandies like Applejack and Calvados, which are made in the various parts of Europe. Now the first thing that we're going to discuss today is whiskey, which is a spirit distilled from grain by the still method. The grain used may be barley, maize, rye, wheat or a mixture of grains in varying proportions. The distilled spirit is then aged in wooden barrels. The minimum aging period is 2 years. Then the types of whiskey that we have are Scotch whiskey. These are generally distilled twice and must be distilled and matured only within Scotland for at least 3 years in oak cask. Second is Irish whiskey, which is generally distilled 3 times and must be aged for a minimum of 5 years in oak cask. Canadian whiskey, they have regulatory requirements of being aged for at least 3 years in a barrel. Most Canadian whiskies are blended of various multigrains. Then American whiskies that may be used using a mash that consists of all the grains mentioned and a proportion of 51%, but that should not be more than 79% of a single grain. Then Japanese whiskey, they are made with both methods, Pottston and Patenston method, made from millet, corn and rice. In this photograph below, you can see various whiskies that we have in the market these days. Now a basic table will differentiate between these things. Scotch, made in Scotland, primary grain is barley. Types of barrels are white, oak barrels. Aging period is 3 years. There are smoky and flavor of malt and peat we get. Made from a single batch is called as single malt if a single grain is used. Common brands are Johnny Walker and Glenlivet. Then Irish whiskey, made in Ireland. Major ingredient is barley. White oak cask reused are used in this particular type. Barrels, then it is also aged for 3 years. Flavor of the malt and barley is there. Pure pot or single malt is used. Jameson and Bushmill are a few examples. Then moving forward, we have bourbon whiskey, which is your Kentucky, made in the United States, made with corn. Char, new white oak barrels are used. Minimum aging is 2 years. Sweeter than most of the other whiskey made than the charcoal flavor. Single batch or a single barrel is used. Jack Daniels is a famous brand which is comes from this category. Jim Beam comes from this particular category. Then Tennessee whiskey, which is made in Tennessee in the United States, made with corn. Charred, new white oak barrels are used, a minimum period of 2 years. Sweeter than most other flavors that we use. Small batches are made. Jack Daniels and George Dickley are a few brands which are used. And the last category that we have is Canadian whiskey, made with rye. White oak barrels are used. Minimum aging is 4 to 5 years. Usually lighter in taste than others. Single malt is used. Seagram's 7, Crown Royal are a few brands in this particular category. Then various brand names for Scotch, we have Glenfiddich, Glenlivet, Johnny Walker Blue Label, Jura, Macallan. Irish whiskey, we have Jameson, Bushmill, Middleton. For Canadian whiskey, we have Canadian Club, Crown Royal, Walker Special. For American whiskey, we have Jim Beam, Jack Daniel, Four Roses. And for Japanese whiskey, we have your Nikka, Yamakaze, Hibiki, and Yoshi, which are famous brands from that particular country. Then moving forward, brandy. Brandy is a spirit distilled from grapes. The spirit distilled from any other fruit other than grapes are called as fruit brandies. They are also consumed as after dinner drinks. Brandies are produced by all the countries that produce wines. Cognac and Armagnac are the brandies from France. Cognac happens to be the best available brandy in the market. Here you can see a few photographs of brandy glasses, a brandy balloon, and a brandy bottle of Hennessy here in this particular photograph. Then types of brandies are your grape brandies, which are produced by the distillation of fermented grape juice. Armagnac is made from grapes of the Armagnac region of southwest France. Cognac comes from the Cognac region in France and is double distilled using the pot still method. Fruit brandies are those which are made from fruits other than grapes. UOTB is a general French term for fruit brandies, like Calvados made with apple, Kirschwasser made with cherries, and Silvertes made with plums. These are your fruit brandies, the basic two types, grape brandies and fruit brandies. Aging indication on barrels. In order to differentiate various types of brandies, a basic indication of the age is done in that on that particular label. AC stands for 2 years old, aged in wooden barrels. VS stands for very special, is often called 3-star. VSOP, very superior old peel, minimum aging is 5 years in wooden barrels. It is also called as 5-star. XO, extra old, minimum aging of 6 years, and includes Napoleon and Vieille Reserve. Then Napoleon, which is at least 4 years old, mostly much older than 4 years. Then Vintage, it must be stored in the cask until it's the time it's bottled, showing the date of the vintage on it. So basically, this is the kind of labeling that is done on the bottles of your brandy. Brandy names: Hennessy, Martell, Remy Martin, Corrosser, Jonio, Schauberg, Sempe. These are some famous brands which are there available in the market. You can see the basic photographs as well. Then moving forward, we have tequila. Tequila is a Mexican liquor distilled from the fermented juice of blue agave, Tequila Weber. To label as tequila, it must come from the area surrounding tequila. Tequila is most often made at 37 to 40% alcohol content. Tequila has a high alcohol content and it is made in Mexico. It is served in shot glasses and with lemon wedges, as you can see in the photograph below, and salt. Then types of tequila. Blanco is the first type, white or silver, unaged, held in stainless steel barrels for less than 60 days. Reposado, aged for 1 year. Angios, darker than Reposado, smoother and mellower, aged for minimum 2 years, and the most expensive. So, Angios is the one which is the most expensive. Jovan o Gabo, unaged dark golden color. And Mezcal, which is a similar to tequila plant, which is approved by the government, and the areas and the species of the agave used in this particular are approved to be 30. Then various brand names: Sosa, Oscuro, Cabo, Don Julio, Casa Noval, Herradura, Monte Alban are a few basic brands of tequila which are famous in the market. So thank you so much for taking your time and watching my video. For any comments or questions, please put them in the chat box. Do like and subscribe my videos. Have a nice day. In the next video, we'll be talking about wines. Thank you.